The best of Merv Burd on the radio.
Breakfast with Gordon Sparks. BBC Radio Devon.
Social distance this morning, our pause for thought guest. It's only straight past the Mervyn Burd from Tibby. Morning, Merv.
Oh, good morning, Gordon. I mean, don't you and Dad look with say a bit muggy and fuzzy this morning?
Thank you for the live update from Tiverton. Brilliant. Let's have your pause for thought for today, please, Merv.
Well, here we go. I begin where I plan to end this morning. Tweet, 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 tweet. That's how it ends. You see, since the early days of life for me and throughout life itself, I've sought to have an attitude of gratitude. So today, will you, will me, will we be grumpy, full of gloom and doom? I mean, come on, let's get catchy in our heads. Tweet, 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 tweet. Let's pack up our troubles and get our old gloom back.
Thank you very much indeed. Have you had a sprinkle this morning?
Thank you very much for playing Eliza Doolittle the other morning.
She liked that, did she? She was bopping around?
She was singing it all day long again.
Well, I'm glad that woke her up.
Tweet, 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 tweet. Oh, it's good, she said. And it's catchy as well. Do you know, this just got me thinking. How many of us hear a song or a track? It seems to stick with us and it keeps returning into our head. Tweet, 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 tweet. Rejoice and be glad. This is the day that the Lord has made. You see, in the early part of this year, I was diagnosed with prostate cancer. So thank you to oncology at Wanford Hospital, given treatments for cancer and looking after us, dear folks, in so many ways. You are more than marvellous. And just a quick shout-out, but a serious one for men out there listening this morning. Maybe you're at the breakfast table, maybe driving to work, in whatever place this finds you right now as you listen. If the symptoms for you in that area, don't do a Merv. Don't do a Merv. Don't keep putting it off. Don't say I haven't got time. Make time. Get out. Get on. Get in to see a doctor for a PSA test. You see, that will sort your needs out. It just may save your life.
You know, that's a big thing you've said on the radio. To say that on the radio, that's a massive thing, Merv. Take in with you the thought that everybody listening to this show is with you and wishing you well.
Thank you, Gordon. Have a good day, man.
You too. We shall see. Nice tease towards Kevin. Kevin enjoyed, he mentioned it on air as well, he enjoyed your pause for thought yesterday, no doubt.
Oh,
Kevin.
Bless him. Yes, I heard him mention it. Bless him. Yeah.
And Kevin, no doubt, with many others, wondering what you're going to give us today, Marvin.
I want to tell you the story this morning about these are two young twin boys. How different they were. If one felt the weather was going to be hot, the other said it's going to rain. That's because, you see, one was an optimist, the other a pessimist. And yes, I've had a bit of rain, haven't I, the last 24 hours? I mean, the slugs think it's happy days.
Yeah, you're right. On my garden path, I've had a bit of live sport. I've had live slug racing this week.
You are, see? Yeah.
Oh, get on.
You've heard the saying that is so true that honesty is the best policy. Or, if it's too good to be true, it probably is. You see, good things happen to both optimists and pessimists. But they view those victories in very different ways. One would say to all challenges, I can. The other would say, I can't.
Oh, get on.
If you want to tell the difference between optimistic and pessimistic people, ask them how their life has been up to this point. The answer will reveal. Tweet, 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 tweet. Look what I have, he said. Horse manure. He went running at the door, shouting with excitement, handstands and cartwheels. It is possible to have a bright outlook on the future.
Well, bless you for allowing us into your home this morning. I'll tell you what was a surprise. I had a couple of chums around yesterday to sit socially distanced in the garden, Merv. And we were in the garden. Oh, I was nearly ripping my shirt off yesterday.
As a former volunteer said to me of years ago, he said, fog in the morning, boy. Fog in the morning of the day. There'll be some sun on the way.
Oh, get on.
I know what you're thinking, Laura and Gordon, seeing me now. What has gone wrong? The only running I've been doing during this lockdown, it seems, to the fridge and back.
Caroline Cook. BBC Radio Devon.
Mervyn, over to you. Pause for thought.
I still have the clay pot that I made. It's been a reminder over the years of my attempt at pottery, even in school. I have discovered, I'm sure you have as well, truth will always come out in the end. Oh Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay. You're the potter. We're the work of your hands. So pass on the baton of compassion, care, understanding and love. That's the pause for thought for today. So with that sign off in a slightly different way this morning, as I say have a good day, I also say, oh, yours sincerely, Merv. God bless.
The best of Merv Burd on the radio.
Good morning, Dad. I'm giving you this message here from Callimore State in Tiverton, where unfortunately 80% of the population still can't tie their own shoelaces. Unlike you, when I look out the window, I see cars overturned and set on fire because of Black Lives Matter protests. But no, black lives matter, of course they do. Every life matters, doesn't matter whether you're white, whether you're black. But I just want to thank you for being not just my dad or my best friend, but an absolute legend that you are. I mean, you're technically speaking, you're my bank manager, because you always let me use the overdraft. But end of the day, I just want you to know how much you mean to me. And I'm lucky enough that I can call you my dad. And I'm lucky because some people I know, their fathers ain't alive today. So happy Father's Day. It's 6:15 in the morning, but I'm having a can just for you. Love you, bye.
Hi Dad, just want to say happy Father's Day. Thanks for everything you've done for me and the other two. Obviously, I know I'm your favourite, but that's how it is. Right, love on this day. Thanks very much. Bye.
Blimey, looks like Dad, you're not the only one who's been running to the fridge and back during lockdown. Lovely to see you, Mark. There seems to be more of you than before. But don't let it worry. Sign of contentment, apparently. Right, what am I doing? Oh, yes. Father's Day message. Before I do, Dad, just want to say well done on what you've done on the radio last week. I've had so many people contacting me saying you had a positive effect on their lives. So I just want to say tweet, 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 tweet. Okay, Father's Day. To be fair, we haven't done too bad when it comes to fathers. Now, I appreciate you're a little bit concerned how the other two sons have turned out. But panic not, you got it spot on with me. I'm currently in my van and I'm just about to go and do the Lord's work. So amen to that. But on a serious note, Dad, so proud of you and love you to pieces. And happy Father's Day. Love me. Take care. Bye-bye.